Hello my friends, in this video I'm going to show you how we prepare different types of incubation substrates that we use at BION Terrarium Center to incubate eggs of different reptiles. Basically we use three types of incubation substrate, perlite, vermiculite and Seramis. We use them for different species, we use them for different ecological groups. Seramis is mainly used for Uroplatus, Rhacodactylus, Felizuma and Eurydactylodes species. And perlite is used for terrestrial geckos of the genus Nephrurus. Sometimes we use it also for Eublepharidae species. While vermiculite is used for example, Microlophus, Petrosaurus, Xenogamma and other species of our beautiful reptiles. I will use some eggs to show you how we do it. Don't worry, they are artificial, not real eggs. And in the following video, you will see the steps which we undertake to prepare the substrate, the incubation box, as soon as we found an egg or a clutch of many eggs. So let's go. Vermiculite. So first of all, we have to sift the dry substrate to get rid of dust and particles that are too small. Sometimes when such particles are very numerous, they can be harmful for the eggs while developing. After that, we fill the box with the substrate and the depth is 2-3 centimeters. After that, we fulfill it with water. For example, for this box, we need about 300 milliliters of water. After that, we shake the substrate thoroughly and leave it for 15, 20 or 30 minutes to allow vermiculite to soak in the moisture. After that, we make small holes in the substrate and place the eggs as we want, leaving some space between the eggs as they will grow while being incubated and they will need some additional space for this growth. After that, we close the incubation box. This box already has the holes, the ventilation holes drilled, and after that we put it inside the incubator. When it comes to perlite, we use so-called ALBI method with mixing certain amount of perlite with a certain amount of water. You can read more about this method using the link that is on the video. We also begin with the sifting of the powder. Perlite usually has more powder, so we get rid of it and we try to leave as many big particles as we can, so from 4 to 8 millimeters in diameter. After that we measure the weight of our dry perlite and count 80% of this weight and take this amount of water. So if we have, for example, 100 grams of dry perlite, we need to mix it with 80 grams of water. We also carefully mix the whole substrate with water. And again, let it wait for 30 minutes up before putting eggs inside. Yes, after that we close the box and make necessary markings on it and put it inside the incubator. If we work with Seramis, I have to mention that it almost doesn't have any powder inside, so first thing that we do is filling the whole amount of Seramis that we are going to use inside our incubation boxes with hot boiled water. This is done to disinfect the particles that are inside the box. When the mix of Seramis and hot water cools down, we pour the water out and fulfill it again with water of room temperature. After that, we pour the water out again and shake it a bit. After that, we make holes, place eggs inside, and that's all. Again, we close the incubation box and put it inside the incubator or somewhere inside the room where we are going to incubate the eggs of our reptiles. Please keep in mind that we don't teach anybody to do anything. We are just sharing our experience and the methods that we use and that are successful in our facilities. To see more interesting videos and other information that we readily share with our subscribers, please follow us on Facebook, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and stay safe.